Hello, this is Rally Mangubat and you're watching Drum Basics Season 2. Hi, today we're going to finish the song Change the World. This is episode 1.3 of Drum Basics Season 2. The last episode talks about re-intro going to a fill build-up to the chorus. Okay, so just to give you a recap of the last episode, of the last Change the World episode, we started with a bass drum and a crescendo to a mezzo forte and a fill to the floor tom going to the chorus, right? And this is how it sounds, just to give you a recap. So we started with a 4E of the last bar, which is 4E, and then a bass drum towards the 1 to the next bar. So 4E and 1. The floor tom on A, 3 A, and 4 end on the floor tom to finish that particular bar. So it's 1 and after that build up feel from the last episode, we start off this episode with a chorus. And that's beginning with the chorus, the backbeat, 2 and 4 playing a strong snare, okay? And it goes down to a full 8-bar phrase and a short fill. And then afterwards, there's an extension of that chorus for another 4 bars, which I think serves as a build-up or a preparation for the guitar solo. So this is a slight variation on the length of the form of that chorus. So let's hear. I'm gonna play you the 8-bar chorus, right? And I'll stop at the 7th bar. That's bar 60, okay? And we'll dissect the bar 61, which is the fill in towards the extra 4. Okay, so this is how it sounds, the first 8, first 7 of that chorus. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We play the 8th bar of that chorus that we're talking about, okay, the first chorus after the for this season. It comes up with a short feel, right, and a very quick hi-hat opening. So this is how it sounds like. Normally, when you follow the rules of right and left, this particular part falls on the left hand. However, just to demonstrate, if we start with the left hand lead, this would challenge you to play the right hand, as it actually goes from snare to the tom. Now, the only challenge is there's a time difference that you play from the snare to the tom. And this would actually slow you down. So for that right left hand rule, it is more suggested that we just start with the right hand towards the next bar. So again, this is how it sounds like. Okay. Watch when I play it with the left hand. So there's a very slight lag, because technically these two here, when you do it like that, it's a little bit challenging, okay? From that movement is challenging. So it's really up to you. Whichever is comfortable, you can use that. On my end, since I'm right-handed, it's more comfortable starting with the right hand. So crash it. Right, left, right, crash. Go ahead and play the full 8 bars and stop at the 8th bar, which is bar 61. And then we continue. Okay, this is how it works. Mentioned earlier, we're going to play the extra 4 bars after that 8 bar chorus. This particular part is placed to make preparations to introduce the guitar solo. Okay, so it's an extra 4 bar phrase after the chorus. Okay, so let's go ahead and play that. Play that guitar solo, but just to let you know first that it's being introduced by an 8-note hi-hat, open hi-hat, that comes from the 4-bar phrase, extra phrase from that chorus that we played. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with that 8 open 8 hi-hat, 8 note hi-hat towards that first downbeat of the guitar solo. Okay, this is how it sounds. So it's 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Going to play the last chorus of the song Change the World. This particular chorus comes after that guitar solo that we played earlier, okay? And this chorus also starts with a crash, okay? Just to make that recap, earlier the crash is actually added towards a variation on that chorus to identify single out the choruses that we've been playing. This allows us to differentiate it from the other choruses that we played earlier. It's not just accentuating the chorus part or introducing the chorus part, it's we're going there, but it's a whole new variation that J.R. Robinson added, right? Reason being is because he wants more emphasis on those choruses, right, compared to the choruses that he played earlier. And that, for me, is very functional and efficient. Think about that, okay? So, but for now, let's go ahead and play this particular chorus part. I'll be playing the first 8 of the chorus as there's an extension again after this chorus, okay? So let's go ahead and play that first 8 right now. Okay, so right now we're gonna play the last five bars extra of this song before we play the outro. This particular five bars is an extra phrase after the last chorus. And the difference about this is there's a lot of crashes being played, and also there's a fermata. The fermata is actually, should I say, is defined as a short pause. That's in layman's term. So it's being used to introduce a part or to change tempos. However, for this one, it's used to introduce the outro. Okay, so to make sure that there's a particular difference, and there would be a significance of introducing that the song is going to end. So that's how I understand it. Okay, so let's go ahead and play that last five bars and see how it sounds. Okay. Alright, so right now we're gonna play the last part of the song, which is actually a four-bar phrase, and this starts with an eight-note open hi-hat. This is the outro. Okay, let's go ahead and play that outro, starting with that eight-note hi-hat. So I'm gonna count it off, okay? So it's one, and two, and three, and four. So that's the end of episode 1, the song Change the World via drummer extraordinaire J.R. Robinson. I hope you like that episode. There are more drum lessons to come to the next following episodes that will be featuring my favorite drummers and artists. And this is again a free drum lesson for everybody, okay? And also watch out for my drum transcriptions. It's gonna be out very soon. There will be a website that will host those drum transcriptions for you to download. This would feature the lessons that we have for my channel, so you can refer to the lessons as you want to study those songs by yourself. Again, this is Rally Mangubat saying goodbye for now. I hope you enjoyed this episode.